arrange for this very kind introduction. So my duty is to moderate the panel discussion, so we can have kind of a lively, hopefully lively discussion. I understand the room is not that cozy to have discussion, but we try to take the floor. We have a number of panelists. I invite the two other panelists to come to the to come here. So I'm asking our colleagues from Korea to join our two colleagues, Woody and Nilüfer. So please, Mr. Jun Bong Han and Mr. Professor Nam, Dr. Nam. I'm sorry with the Korean names, I'm not really good at pronunciating them, but I apologize really. As I was introduced, I can speak Japanese, but I cannot speak Korean, so I'm very sorry I have to do that in English. I can also speak French and Spanish, but not Korean, so I'm very sorry. So we try to have, I was saying before, kind of a live discussion also, the room is not perfect for that. I feel a bit far from my panelists, but we try to do that. I think we already hear a number of very important things about NVIDIA networks and how it is important for regional seas conservation and regional seas governance. But there is still a number of things that we can ask ourselves and ask the panelists. And we really like also to give you the opportunity to take the floor, the audience can take the floor, not only the panelists, and in order to exchange ideas. As we already hear quite a lot about the Mediterranean and not that much about Yellow Sea, so I will maybe begin by asking our Korean friends to give us maybe a little more details about what are the challenges and they are facing for the conservation of the Yellow Sea and for setting NPAs and NPA networks in this region. So maybe I will ask you to give us some more details about the conservation efforts for the Yellow Sea and the Korean National Park Services. So please, about the floor.
국립공원관리공단의 안중환입니다. 저희 국립공원관리공단은요, 서해 해양 보존을 위해서 다양한 안전들을 수행하고 있습니다. 뭐, 선수들은 몇 가지 말씀드려보면, 먼저 해양 보호 구역과 NPA 네트워크를 확대하기 위해서 지속적으로 노력하고 있습니다. 두 번째로는 그 해양 보호 구역 내에 해양 생태계에 대한 지속적인 연구와 또한 그 NPA 정보 시스템을 구축하기 위해서도 그 위협을 지속하고 있습니다. 세 번째로는 서식지의 보존, 예를 들어보면은, 해초지의 보건 사업이라든지, 이런 해양생태계 서식지의 보건에 있어서도 다른 어느 국내의 보존기관보다 앞장서서 앞서나가고 있습니다. 네 번째로는, 물론, 국립공원 지역 내에 해당되겠지만은, 해양 오염 방지를 위해서 해양마을에 모스킨트를 설치하고 관리를 지속해나가고 있으며 해양 쓰레기에 대한 수거의 처리를 해나가고 있습니다. 마지막으로 지속적으로 중요성이 강조되어 온 갯벌 지역을 직접적으로 관리, 보존하기 위해서 갯벌 지역에 국립공원 지정을 위해서 최선의 노력을 다하고 있습니다.
Dr. Nam, want to add something on this topic of what is the, let's say, the challenge, main challenge for addressing NPAs and NPA network in the Yellow Sea?
Thank you very much, Mr. I'm a researcher and working for the Korean Maritime Institute. And this institute is governed affiliated research institute. We are working for the government and to develop national policy in the field of marine and fishery and coastal areas. So, as a researcher to deal with these issues, I have been involved in marine coastal issues for many, many years, the last 2 decades. I worked for these issues. So I know that we also work for these issues for the last 2 decades. So in terms of the MPA network in the LOC, Korean Maritime Institute actually initiated the MPA network. So in 2008, Korean Maritime Institute initiated this initiative, this initiative to the LOC. And then we secured a fund from 2013. So we secured a 5-year fund for enhance the MPA networks based on capacity buildings and the other things. So from 2009, we have already hosted 3 annual meetings in a cooperation with the LOC Reservoir Ecosystem Project. And nowadays we are approaching to the 1st annual meeting. So as one of the reasons we have to focus on the LOC MPA network is just to enhance the ecological health of the LOC and them. So deal with the transboundary issues. Our major focus goes on to the transboundary issues, something like that, the spotted seals, and then the transboundary protected areas between 2 Koreas. Those are the 2 major concerns we have to start to get the interest on these issues. But unfortunately, actually many people say that. So we got MPA networks, we got so many, many capacity buildings programs. But unfortunately, I don't see the really, really genuine outcome, not output. Actually, output means just the institutional and the legal coverage. For example, we have about so many meetings, we got the declaration, we got so the terms of references, blah, blah, blah. But I don't think that it would not guarantee the genuine and success. So we need what outcome, even though it is not guaranteed, it's not documented by some papers. So actually, even though we started too late in terms of the MPA network establishment, but there are many expertise for the LOC Reservoir Ecosystem. I could not see any peculiar, outstanding progress. But I don't. I don't have the pessimist approach to this issue. So just that we are going and going and going and going on. So I would like to recommend to have a focus on the transboundary issues on these areas. Actually, 7 years ago, the Korean government initiated the transboundary issues between the 2 Koreas. It was titled in the Marine Peace by Korea between 2 Koreas. Actually, this area is very important in terms of the ecological and economic aspect. As one example, there are 68 coast and marine protected areas on the transboundary areas between 2 Koreas, especially in the western part of the Korean Peninsula. So that's why we have much focus on these areas. And then, so one of the living resources there in the area. Spotted seals might be the ecological guide. 3 countries, China, North Korea, and South Korea. Actually, the spotted seals moves on from the Baekje Island, which is the northern part of South Korea. It is located in the transboundary areas between the Koreas. And it moves on to the western part of North Korea. And moves on to the Bohai Sea, like the China Capital Sea area. It is separately a lot of moves on these journeys. So that's I think that spotted seals might be a symbol of the classical network of the general sea. And then so we need to focus on this area, these living resources. So
So actually, Dr. Jay explained about that the upcoming event on the annual meeting for the very important areas of these regional cities. But I'd like to correct I'd like to give the correct date. So October from 9 to the 11th of October is we will have the first annual meeting for the LOC regional MPA networks. Thank you very much.
Okay, thank you very much, Dr. Nam, for this explanations. Is there somebody in the audience that wants to take also the floor to give us some more explanation or some information about this LOC issue? Or if somebody wants to take the floor, please just raise your hand and pass a microphone. Then it's not really easy to raise your hand like this. But well, think about it and maybe come back later to that. Well, you raised a number of issues in your comments. I think the issue of transboundary MPA is clearly very important for the LOC. It's also important for the Mediterranean. Maybe Puri or Minister, you want to talk about the issue of transboundary. It's the importance of having networks for fixing or for working together on transboundary.
Yes, I think this is a crucial issue in a small and close sea such as the Mediterranean. And it's not easy. It's obvious in terms of ecology, but it's not obvious in terms of politics, because the typical way of work is inside each country more than outside. We have, fortunately, we have the Barcelona Convention, that this is the first step for a common governance, but there is not a long tradition of cooperation regarding marine issues. There, I fully agree it's necessary when we look at the map that Cora showed to us coming from this first proposal of the rights path for the Mediterranean. I think that they look also at trying to avoid as much as possible more than two countries involved in the creation of high seas protected areas. But despite this issue, there are always at least two that must be involved. I know better the west side of the Mediterranean. The Alboran Sea, it's obvious that just we can just protect that if we work with Morocco and Spain. Some progress has been made, but it's not really to be declared. And exactly the same for certain canyons in the border with France and Spain. There was some progress of working together in terms of collecting information, but finally the political decision is not always easy. And that's why I think that the governance is something that is important to be put not just on the hands of heads of state and politicians. It's important the capacity of civil society from different countries working together, because unless we do that in this way, there will be never enough lobby inside the country to ask the politicians to take these steps to establish common marine protected areas with other countries. So, I think that unfortunately we are still far from the final declaration, but we have a lot of progress in terms of arguments, in terms of information, and in terms of ecological coherence. So I hope that if we are also working with rising awareness on the civil society as a whole, this will help a lot to really make our politicians understand that marine protection cannot be done only in the territorial waters. They need to go further. They need to go even to the high seas. But, well, this is part of our challenge, but it's a real challenge.
Thank you. Again, if there is any people in the room that want to take the floor. Okay, we have two, it's good. So maybe, yes, Mr. Nibani, please. You can speak in French, I think there are the translation. So.
Thank you, Mr. Francois. La même chose pour la Méditerranée. Donc, c'est pas simplement la mère qui est partagée, et vous savez peut-être mieux que moi qu'il y a un stock partagé, puisque le poisson il n'est pas tout à fait sédentaire et il mange. Donc à ce niveau-là, donc par rapport à la gestion, je viens de la ville d'Arcisina où il y a un parc national Nava, on m'avait posé une question. Cette année-là, on a des captures qui ont diminué de 70%. Donc, il n'y a pas d'autre facteur. On se demande si c'est l'effort de pêche locale ou on se demande si c'est les changements climatiques qui ont fait les migrations. Donc, ce sont des ouvriers, donc, mettre le poids, ce sont beaucoup d'éléments qui entrent en plus des éléments anthropiques, politiques et humains. Il y a des facteurs qui sont climatiques. Et donc, en l'absence d'une vraie stratégie où il y a plusieurs partenaires qui doivent pour gérer. Par exemple, nous, en tant que petite ONG pour la protection de l'environnement, on n'est pas des experts. Pourtant, on nous demande de donner notre avis et pour que les gens, que les pêcheurs puissent comprendre. Et on nous demande de travailler avec eux pour avoir un plan d'action. Donc, on ne peut pas faire un plan d'action local si le problème touche les pays. Donc, je crois que l'UICN pourrait bien sûr contribuer à gérer cette politique entre les pays pour trouver des standards, même s'ils ne sont pas stables, mais assez, sur le plan scientifique, assez reconnu, parce que c'est des stratégies pour améliorer.
Merci beaucoup. Je crois que c'est intéressant, c'est très important d'avoir l'avis ici de quelqu'un qui travaille au niveau local, une ONG locale qui nous dit qu'effectivement, quel que soit le travail, qu'il soit localement, c'est toujours très important d'avoir d'autres personnes, d'autres partenaires avec qui on veut échanger des idées et avec qui on veut réussir effectivement à résoudre les problèmes qu'on trouve localement, que d'autres aussi peuvent rencontrer localement. Is there other voice here that from small local NGOs that would like to take the floor and tell us something? Yes, please.
Yeah, 한국말로 하겠습니다. 저는 전라북도, 그러니까 황해 지역에 포함되어 있는 해남군 간척사암이라고 하는 지역에서 연구조사와 보존원 활동을 하고 있습니다. 이 지역은 간척 면적이 400평방킬로미터입니다. 그 간척을 하면서 동아시아 이동하는 그 많은 도요새들의 감소를 가져왔습니다. 약 16만 마리 감소를 가져왔습니다. 그래서 제가 새를 조사하다 보니까 우리나라뿐만 아니라 북한이나 중국 쪽에도 많은 새들이 이동하면서 중간 기착을 하는 걸 알게 됐고, 그에 따라서 많은 외국의 NGO들과 전문가들과 함께 같이 조사도 하고 보고서를 내고 있습니다. IUCN에서 낸 보고서가 이번에 보고서가 나왔고, 오늘 저녁에 7시에 다른 워크샵을 통해서 발표할 예정입니다. 한국의 새만금 사업 같은 지금 개발들이 여전히 이루어지고 있습니다. 인천 공항 주변에 대단히 조력발전 계획이 있고요. 그 외에도 여기 제주의 강정마을 앞에 지금 유네스코가 지정한 생물권 보전 지역임에도 불구하고 해군기지가 지금 공사를 진행하고 있습니다. 이와 같이 한국 내에서 많은 개발들이 이루어지고 있기 때문에 NPA 지역이 있다 하더라도 상당한 어떤 그 생태계적인 압력이 계속 작용한다고 보고 있습니다. 따라서 더 이상 한국 내에서의 연안 개발 이런 문제가 다시금 중단이 되거나 재검토가 돼야 된다고 보고, 중국도 많은 보하이만을 비롯한 많은 지역들이 연안이 간척되고 개발되고 있습니다. 따라서 3개국이 협력해서 진정으로 보조를 위한 협력이 이루어져야 되겠고, 거기에는 정부만이 아니라 NGO나 각국 정부 내의 전문가들이 꼭 참여를 해서 객관적인 노력이 좀 필요하다는 생각입니다. 현재 와덴시 쪽에 3개국이 협력해서 보존을 하고 있습니다. 그와 같은 사례들을 저는 우리 내, 한국 내, 또 예루시 내에 적용하는 것이 중요하다고 보고, 오늘 논의가 된 이 지중해 지역의 그 관리 방안에 대해서도 같이 협력을 한다면 미래에 상당히 지금 현재 황해 지역의 도전의 문제를 좀 해결하는 데 도움이 되지 않겠나 하는 생각이 들어서 말씀드렸습니다.
Thank you very much. I think you put your finger on something which is quite important, is the role of